Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and many of us use iPhones because of their overall security and privacy, meaning much of our device information is left on the device and much more. However, there's an important issue I wanted to make you aware of where iPhone has a serious problem. So here's what you need to know. Apple has a new phishing attack targeting iPhone users, which was noted by Krebs on Security. They reported this and it tries to trick users into giving people their information. Users who have experienced this issue report that this is done by popping up a reset password dialog on iPhone over and over until you've had enough and just tap allow or sort of just give in. You'll see here's an example of what it looks like. Here's a little close-up version of it, and it gives you tons of prompts, hundreds possibly. So basically you'll get dozens of system level prompts that force you to select allow or don't allow. If you click allow, it could give you a code, and since this is system level, it will pop up on all the devices attached to your Apple ID or phone number. This stops you from being able to use your phone, as there could be hundreds of prompts you need to click through just to get back to the home screen. It could pop up on your iPhone, your Apple Watch, your iPad or Mac, or even Vision Pro. Now, even if you don't click allow, you'll receive a call from a scammer who will then pretend to be Apple support. They're spoofing the number and making it look like they're genuinely from Apple, but they're not at all. The person pretending to be from Apple will confirm your account is under attack and that they need information to secure your account and stop the attack. So they're basically looking for information on the other line for a one-time code so they can get access to your account using your password and two-factor authentication or other information. This actually seems to be done by the scammer using the page to reset your password. So if you're using I Forgot, or you just go to Apple and tap on Forgot Password, then you go to enter your information. You can enter an email or phone number. It will then give you a prompt asking for the full phone number. If you have that full phone number, you can then tap Reset Password and it will send a prompt to all your phones. I'll show you what it looks like. And on my device, when I go to reset my password, I can allow or don't allow. You could get hundreds of these over and over and over. So the thing that's unclear is how they're actually giving hundreds of different prompts all at once. That part is still yet to be discovered, but there's a couple things you can actually do. This seems to be using your iCloud account information with the linked phone number, and in turn, you get spammed over and over. This type of attack is actually called an MFA fatigue or push bombing, which is exploited using a vulnerability in the two-factor authentication system. The prompt itself will not give attackers any access to your device, but it's part of a trick trying to trick you into giving them your information when they call. So here's what you can do if you actually run into this issue. So if we tap don't allow, what we can do to protect against this is of course tap don't allow and just sort of keep doing that. Make sure to decline it if you believe you're being attacked with the reset password alerts. Also, if you do receive a call right after those alerts, don't answer the phone call. Even if it says it's from Apple support, if it happens right after you're getting a bunch of prompts and you didn't try and reset it yourself, ignore it altogether, maybe add it to your spam list as well. However, it could look like it's coming directly from Apple, even if it isn't. If you continue to get repeated prompts, and if you can get into your account, try to change your associated phone number temporarily that's associated with your Apple ID. However, this will affect iMessage and FaceTime until you change it back, or maybe give it to other people that you're using a new number. You can also associate the account with different email addresses as well without a phone number. So that's something you can do. If you don't use iMessage or FaceTime, this will be much easier to sort of get around and mitigate. Now, if it does happen to you, I would suggest you contact Apple directly using 1-800-MY-APPLE or go to an Apple store and make sure that they know this is happening to more people. So far, people here that have spoken to them based on this article talked to Apple engineers who initially said that enabling account recovery key would fix the issue, but it doesn't seem to fix the issue. So if you have account recovery key enabled, that doesn't seem to actually fix the issue in general. It may help with it a little bit, and that's in your settings. If we go into settings and then we go to our account, under sign in and security, we have account recovery. You'll see at the bottom, we have recovery key. If you have that enabled, it should help, but don't lose that recovery key or you won't be able to gain access to your device after that. Also within settings, one other thing that could help is if we go into Face ID and passcode, if we scroll down and have stolen device protection, we should enable that just in case when it's away from familiar location or always. I actually got prompted on my phone when I tried to send that alert to myself, where it wouldn't let me pop it up because it said stolen device protection was on. So that may be a way to mitigate it. Apple has not commented at all on this though. So people have reached out to Apple and so far they haven't commented on it. So until we actually hear something from Apple, whether they've fixed it with iOS 17.4.1, we don't really know, but it looks like we may need a server-side patch as well as maybe a patch on the iPhone or one or the other. So we could have an iOS 17.4.2 to help mitigate that issue on the iPhone, or it could be on the server side. Again, Apple hasn't commented, so we don't know 100%. But hopefully that gives you enough information as to what's going on and what you can do to protect yourself if you're having this issue. If you have had this issue, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below and let me know how it went for you. Were you able to get around it? And any tips you actually received from Apple, I'd love to hear from, as I'd like to make sure that this was actually found by Apple if they haven't heard about it enough already. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.